of January, we are basically, I have already introduced, I think, some lectures on machine learning. The basic things of difference between C and Java and Python. The Python can handle large amount of data. That large data means it's not kilobyte or gigabyte. It can be hectabyte, petabyte, this order. So this handling, it is possible through Python, through not Python alone. So you already exposed to NumPy, the NumPy, because it is basically a competition between MATLAB and Python. I think MATLAB you are aware of, it is a licensed software. This is one of the very useful tool. Generally, it is lovable by all the non-programmers, mainly electronics, civil engineers, architecture. They do some all model testing and all these things through this MATLAB software. This is two MIT engineers, they have done it, and this is one of the top 3-4 software companies in MATLAB. MATLAB is all licensed and Python is all is free. So that's it. How can it does it? Yeah. This is the way the Python handle it lightly. I think let's concentrate on this. I think everybody can concentrate on this. So this is, what is this? Basically, three columns. Am I correct? This is three columns. It is called Panda series, PD series, and this series can make a table sort of thing, and it is called a Panda data frame. So what is basically difference? It is this, that it generally in whenever you go for Excel sheet or relational table, we focus on rows. Okay, not here. It is only the columns. The restriction is that the only column length has to be equal. Okay, all columns should be of equal length, and this is called Panda data frame. It can handle huge amount of data. That means megabyte, petabyte. It can, and a data frame can consist a data frame can consist a data frame, and basically this series. This is data frame consists of number of series, and this series basically difference between this series and a NumPy is this is a dictionary. Okay, so you can index it by 0, 1, 2, 3, or you can index it by any other. You can index by name also, dictionary. So each of them is a dictionary, and this is a series, and only restriction is, and it can be any data type. Okay, it can be any data type. It can be mix and match. Not all these things. This is the very powerful tool on data frame. So pandas built up NumPy arrays with series and data frame. So what is series? This is series, and the series can be indexed by numerical index 0, 1 like NumPy, but NumPy cannot be a dictionary. A NumPy this thing, that is cannot be a dictionary. Dictionary, whatever you have learnt in a Python, that's great, but here we can get the both advantage of a NumPy and dictionary. That's it. So you can have index it in the dictionary wise or index wise, and only restriction with the data series that all columns should be equal, and you can have a data frame can consist of data frame that is a multiple same length. That's all. And this is what is the use for. This is very huge for handling large data. Like you need, right now we have a say virus detection, prevention, lots of software. We are testing that which live population should be given data. So you have to handle a very large amount of data. These data, it is very difficult to handle through NumPy, because the NumPy, everything is good about NumPy, but NumPy is purely numerical. Okay, and it cannot be indexed by a dictionary sort of thing. So here it is not, but it has been shown if the data is say around 500,000 and less, then the NumPy implementation is better. But whenever the data is maybe the 500,000 and more, the pandas give the better. The pandas is another data structure that is give this advantage. So here is the basic Python. This is the NumPy. Without NumPy, Python is basically useless. With NumPy, whenever you add all the linear algebra solution, like NumPy has only limited mean, max, all this is. Whenever you have all the curve fitting on all the linear algebra, eigenfunction, eigenvalues, so So all this linear resolution we can get in SciPy, and whenever you have all the graphics features in Matplotlib, and if you put the datas into data, and if you put a data frame sort of thing, what is the, you basically, it is basically a relational table, but the difference between relational table is, relational table is all the rows of equal. No, here it is totally different concept of relational table. Those who are aware of RDBMS, here it is a columnized data, and the column should be all equal, which is not their relational. And relational table say all the rows has to be unique and all. Here it is not said that. You can have a duplicate, same column can be duplicated here. Here this can be duplicated, so there is no such issue. But it is a rectangular data form. It is a rectangular data form. It is not like this. That's it. And but this this form, this data frame, can handle a huge amount of data. Like whenever the lot of data is being generated, so that data handling is much easier than NumPy. So that is it. The pandas. This is series, and series consists of data frame. Let's go to the next slide. This is, I have already mentioned, pandas built a NumPy arrays with series and data frame. Series contains single set of common data, that is with indices, and data frame is a multiplexer. Another thing we used to, you can put the date time data also. That is, you cannot get it in C. Here the data is also can be date time. So there is a time series data, you can put it in the series. Columns are need not to be common. Yes, that is, need not to be common data type. That is very different with RDBMS. RDBMS says all the columns should be of same data type. Here it is not. Here it is only says the columns length should be all equal. So if it is a, it is a 10 depth, it is 10, 10. That's all. That is only that it is requirement. This is it. Say this is a this is series names, teams, number. This is and all this can be, these all are basically a dictionaries. It can be dictionaries. So let's do some coding, then it will be more clearer. So I think these are small things. I prefer Google Colab. So this is I already explained for the how much time it is required to give it time. And this is a for any Colab, is there any future, anything is there, it will be automatically imported, like from under this is a, you know, all internal variables are underscore underscore future underscore, like this import print function, import this is, you can, what is the print for pandas version, this is a short name of pandas, so this is the 1.15 version. This is I am creating not data frame, let's first with the series first. Yeah, this is the first example. I am creating a series PD dot series, three cities. I am taking the example from this. I'll share with it my YouTube video. You can get it and my notes also. So PD series, the San Francisco, San USA, Sacramento. This is three cities. All the information details will be there. First, this is series. Okay, it can be list also, but list later on we can put so much of our data the list cannot. Okay, it looks like you can always argue why it is not list. Yeah, but it is a PD series because it is a huge order data will come. Okay, so I run this. So this is index like this 0, 1, 2, same like C like index, like it starts from 0. This is index data type object time. Yeah, it is object time and it is this. Then I can have a city names, I can have a city names like this. Basically then the population, these are the population, then I am creating with the series city name and population, two columns, one side is a city name, these three cities, and there is respective population. See here the value should match, here is a three and here is a three cities. If it is mismatch, then the data frame cannot be done. So this is only the restriction. So I am creating a data frame. So I am discussing, I am just why are learning pandas. Pandas we are learning because we have to handle large amount of data, okay? Maybe gigabyte, petabyte order, which is not possible through NumPy. NumPy is the best solution. What is the difference between what is the negative point of NumPy? NumPy cannot handle NumPy requires all data should be numeric, whether it's a floating point number, an integer. Character handling and in certain point the data is not there. NumPy is only indexed with 0, 1, 2, 3. Data NumPy a series cannot be a dictionary. Where here the pandas every series. The series is the not row wise. Please remember the here the series means a column wise. It's a column wise series and it can be some place may have a value, some place do not have value, NaN and all these things. That is that the all the value should be there not, but there should be some length and that is the index of the length and you can put a dictionary also. You can put it a 0, 1 and also by the content also. This is a series. You can put a number of series into a data frame. It is a rectangle one. You have a series but only restriction is the series length should be all equal. That's it. So, what is the advantage over NumPy? The NumPy you can make all this, but NumPy you cannot have this flexibility, dictionary sort of series it is then. And what is the difference between with RDBMS table? RDBMS table also is rectangular one, but RDBMS table is that all the rows of equal length. Here it is not said, rows should be unique, it is not said, here columns can be duplicated and all these things. So, this is a data structure for handling a large amount of data for various kind of analysis. Mainly data analytics, this kind of thing, pandas are required. So, here we are. So, we have already have a city name and PD data frame is already there. Now I mean, I am putting this data from one of the images. Now, I see the, now you see the beauty of it. So, all the data from other images, it comes here. The data, all the data from one stored images are already there. So, with the data frame, now this data frame, huge data, you can do all these things. This is one, we can go there, see anything we miss there or not. This is the site. This is the site I have already, this is already completed. Let's see, California data set, what is the head? The number 10 points of data, accessing the data, yeah, we can do once more. Yes, let's try, run it from here. This is the version number. This I am running from their program, Colab program. This is the city names, I have already done it. This is the data set, once again from that program. That is the then I can head means that's series name dot head means first 10 data. Like I think in Unix also this command is a first or five data. First 5 data, California has data frame histogram, I think. Yeah, it's a histogram. Automatically they put it in a the grid is without matplotlib, they give it in a already this is there, this is the histogram image, this is it. Today, this is one, so let's go to the PowerPoint again, yeah. So this is the pie, this is a pandas data type, these are all this is allowed data type, it can have date time, which is not there in NumPy, so it is very much. And also time delta category, these are the data that are required for capturing the real time data, which your NumPy or ordinary Python data time cannot give. Characteristics of NumPy array and pandas data frame. So, concept here arrays are homogeneity, here data kinds can be heterogeneous, that is it can have various things. Arrays are mutable, data frame, these two are mutables. Others are more or less. So, let's go. Yeah. Yes. So here the from another example. Say here the example is. From I am creating a data frame. Here you see this is the series. This is one series, the three name Bob, Jane, and team. and their age 20, 30, 40. See, they are equal. This is three names, three ages, and three pet. So this is also a, and we can see the their name is this thing. We can see the example here. You can write on start this. Here we have the import part done anyway. This is the same thing. Yeah, it is giving. This is the, these are all series, and this is a T square is a data frame, and these are the indexes. Indexes can be a dictionary also from the series. That is the advantage. You can see data frame columns and index. And you can different way you can sort it and all these things you can do it. That is it. Today